Buongiorno, Quintacci. Quintacci, welcome to this last philosophy lesson about Herbert Marcuse. Good morning, Miss Margherita. Good morning, Mr. Mateusz, and good morning, Miss Giulia. First, Margherita. The second one, Mateusz. The third one, Giulia. Now, music. Always Donnerstag aus Licht. That means Wednesday on light. Today it's very dark. The sky is very dark, but for this we can listen to this music. Donnerstag aus Licht. In opposite. Wednesday on Light of the German musician of the end of the 20th century, Karlheinz Stockhausen. So, good morning, Mr. Stefano. Good morning, Miss Alessandra, and also Miss Ilenia. Miss Francesca, Miss Elisa, Miss Aurora, Mr. Yari, why are you here? Good morning, Mr. Alberto. Good morning, Miss Alice, Mr. Stefano, Miss Giorgia, Mr. Riccardo, Miss Francesca, and also someone else, and also Miss Marianna. Welcome to this last, your last philosophy pyjama lesson, and also your last, perhaps, I think, your last philosophy lesson in all your life. A very, very, very important philosophy lesson, a very, very important hour of lesson. You are 17, but with someone else external to your class. So, someone else, someone else. Who must? So, we have to stop the music and stop the music and now we can pass to today's joke. Battutaccia in italiano, una battutaccia che si riferisce molto a me. Era un vero poliglotta. Nessuno sapeva storpiare così tante lingue come lui. Bene. So, now we can really begin with the philosophy of Herbert Marcuse. Marcuse was born in Berlin in 1898. He was a German philosophy. His family was Jewish. His father was a well-off businessman. After graduating as doctor in German literature, he became a member of the so-called Frankfurt School in German, whose true name was the Institute for Social Research. That was a group of Marxist philosophers who aimed for an updated version of Marxism, namely for a current development of Marx's thought that afterwards would have called between inverted commas Western Marxism, Western but Marxism, in order to distinguish it from Soviet Marxism Leninism, or otherwise called, between inverted commas, Eastern Marxism. So, during the 20th century, the Marxism was divided into tendencies. The first one was the Western Marxism. The second one, the Eastern Marxism, linked to Soviet Union. So, in 1932, the members of the Frankfurt School, fearing Nazi takeover, the takeover of Nazism, moved before from Germany to Swiss, and then from Swiss to United States. So, in 1940, Marcuse became a USA citizen, and later was hired as a philosophy professor at the University of California, at the University of Berkeley in California. In the 60s, Marcuse became one of the most influencing intellectuals of the students' movement. He became one of the most influencing intellectual of the students' movements, not only in USA, but also in Europe. For this, he was often referred to as the guru, the leader of the new left, but he rejected this name. He died in 1979 during a visit to Germany. His main works are The First Reason and Revolution, published in 1941, Then, Eros and Civilization. Eros and Civilization, published in 1955. And finally, One Dimensional Man. One Dimensional Man, published in 1964. So now we see one of the of these three works, the second one, Eros and Civilization. Its subtitle is A Philosophical Inquiry into Freud. Subtitle: A Philosophical Inquiry into Freud. So, Eros and Civilization, A Philosophical Inquiry into Freud. Well, you got it? So, let's begin. As you can clearly understand from the title I told you, this Marcuse's work, Eros and Civilization, is strictly connected to Freud's psychoanalytical theory, in particular to Freud's work Civilization and His Discontents, published in 1930. Marcuse claims that Freud has understood that in every man lies a constitutive erotic desire, the libido, i.e. the libido, arising from the life drive, but also Freud say that libido is repressed by society. According to Marcuse, Freud has seen also that the libido repression not only produces discontent, but it even causes psychic pain, and in this way rouses the death drive that can explode in sadism and masochism. You know, oh, you remember this, I hope. Clear? Yes? No? Is there someone behind my screen? I'm speaking to Vanvera. To Vanvera? Sto parlando a Vanvera. Are you Vanvera? Yes? Not? Someone answers. Nobody. There is nobody behind my screen, my video. Oh, okay. I am talking with Vanvera. But in Marcuse's Oh, good. Thank you very much, Miss Francesca, Miss Alice. Thank you very much. So, I can go on. But in Marcuse's view, Freud makes a mistake, thinking that the repression of our libido and our psychic suffering are a consequence of the civilization itself, that is, of every kind of civilization. Instead, Marcuse argues that Freud confuses the libido limitation necessary to permit our civilization with the libido repression imposed by those kinds of civilization based on class oppression, That is, the domination of a rich minority on a poor majority. There is a great difference between the necessary repression of a society without classes, a society classless, and instead the repression imposed by the societies based on class oppression, on the division in many classes and on the class oppression. That is the domination of a rich minority over a poor majority. On the contrary, Marcuse, respect to Freud, Marcuse establishes a strong difference between two kinds and degrees, of repression of our libido. The first one, a basic repression. There is a basic repression. The second one, a surplus repression. A surplus repression. So, a basic repression, there is this important difference between a basic repression and a surplus repression. What is the basic repression? The basic repression is the slight limitation necessary to permit our civilization, i.e., it has to allow the common life of human beings, namely the civil society. The basic repression constrains human beings to respect each other, and so it allows the individuals to cooperate, Marcuse's point is that the basic repression corresponds to what Freud has termed, between inverted commas, reality principle. Do you remember the reality principle? However, Marcuse includes in his concept of the reality principle not only the limitation due to the natural reality, but also the limitation due to the social reality, corresponding to some, but not all, moral rulers of the superego. Superego, do you remember superego? These moral rulers are light rulers, a minimal and basic kind of moral rules. Good. I hope. Differently, the surplus repression is the heavier, stronger, harder limitation imposed on people by a minority of individuals who are avid and greedy for money and power. A minority of individuals who are avid and greedy for money and power. These individuals belong to the societies based on class division and especially to the capitalistic society. According to Marcuse, German, Marcuse, capitalists impose on people a surplus repression, not on the basis of the reality principle, but on the basis of the inverted commas performance principle, another kind of principle, the performance principle, not the reality principle, the performance principle. So, you got it? Good. Now, which is the difference between the reality principle and the performance principle? The reality principle compels people to work in order to produce only what is necessary to live in a comfortable way, i.e. without any misery. Instead, the performance principle establishes that people have to work as much as possible to produce more and more goods. Why? In order to increase the company's profits, that is, the richness of the capitalistic class. The richness of the capitalistic class. Of the wealthy upper class. In other words, in order to allow a small minority to live in the luxury. In order to allow a small minority of people to live in the luxury. Throughout, it's clear, yes, not? If you have some question, you can tell me something. You can write your question. Okay. Clear. Thank you very much. Francesca, Miss Francesca, Mr. Mateusz, you are not Vanvera. So I am speaking to you, not to Vanvera. Oh, I'm happy. So let's go on. Throughout the historical development of the societies based on class domination, the performance principle became harder and harder. Hence, human sexuality was more and more repressed. The main means to increase and to strengthen the performance principle and so sexual repression as well was the institution of family. Why? This because family imposed a monogamous relationship, i.e. the fidelity, the absolute fidelity between the spouses. But especially because family imposed that sexuality was permitted only in order to procreate children. Family imposed that sexuality was permitted only in order to procreate children. So, you know that some years ago, many women went to bed with a dress. I don't know the name of the camicia da notte. With a night dress on which it was written, I don't do this for my pleasure, but for God's pleasure. So, what does it mean? It means I have a sexual relation only to procreate children. So I don't do this for my pleasure, but only for God's pleasure. God's pleasure was to procreate many children. Good. which is the aim of this imposition? Enjoy the sexuality only in order to procreate children. Which is the aim of this rule? It is to get a great number of workers, because the higher is the number of workers, the lower is the manpower cost. You know. The higher is the number of workers, the lower is the manpower cost for the capitalistis. In this way, capitalistis can increase more and more their profits and become richer and richer. The final aim of the performance principle is the increasing of capitalists' profits. So now we can do a pause. The last pause of this pyjama philosophy pyjama lesson with I don't know Patti Pravo, Patti Pravo. This one. Do you know Patti Pravo? Patti Pravo. So. Yes. 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 No. No.
Tu mi fai girare, tu mi fai girare.
So, good, very good, a beautiful song, I think. Now. So, do you like Patti Pravo? Did you like this this song? A doll. Are you alive? Still alive? Meglio. Perhaps. So, thank you very much of this of your opinion, Miss Francesca. So we can go on, and so we can finish this last philosophy pyjama lesson and this last philosophy lesson of all your life. So, as a consequence of the family, of the institution of the family, during the time, human libido has been hardly repressed in two ways. The first one, because people haven't spare time enough, because they had to work all the day and also all the night. No more spare time. The second consequence. Because people conceive and practice their sexuality not like a purpose. But only like a means to generate children. So, this means that human libido has been mutilated because it has been reduced to genital sexuality, only a type of sexuality, which is a small part of sexuality, and moreover is conceived, this only genital sexuality is conceived and practiced only as a means for procreation. Instead, Marcuse maintains that the essence of the libido is to be a play, i.e. a game. What does Marcuse mean for play or game? He means an activity, self-oriented. Play is an activity self-oriented. A behavior that doesn't aim for an external purpose. A behavior that doesn't aim for an external purpose, but that is the purpose of itself. In a play, the play is the purpose, the aim of itself. Therefore, as a play, sexuality can and must be realized in many different ways, engaging every part of the body. Of course, in Marcuse's opinion. Marcuse holds that in the second half of 20th century, the sexual repression has reached the peak. This means for him that the contemporary society is afflicted by the highest degree of negation of the libido in human history, in all human history. Contemporary society is afflicted by the highest, the biggest degree of negation of our libido in all the human history. Anyway, Marcuse claims that our libido has remained intact and complete in our consciousness, in our unconsciousness. So everyone holds in himself, everyone holds in himself the memory of his original libido, of his first free sexual life. In our unconsciousness, in our unconscious, there is the memory of our first original free sexual life. This memory emerges in our fantasy, in our dreams, but also in the pieces of art, in the works of art, in the artistic works, in the pieces of art. Consequently, there is a stronger and stronger contradiction. There is a stronger and stronger contradiction between our unconscious and the performance principle, i.e., that is, between our libido and surplus repression. We live, according to Marcuse, everyone lives this contradiction between our libido and surplus repression. This contradiction produces the possibility of a dialectic overturning. This contradiction in us produces the possibility of a dialectic overturning. What is it? The negation of the negation. Do you remember? The negation of the negation. Hegelian and Marxian negation of negation. I.e. the dialectic. No? Do you remember dialectic? So in this way, the contradiction between our libido and the surplus repression due to the performance principle produces the possibility of a socialist revolution based on our sexuality, so on our subjectivity, on the emotional part of people. So, in other words, Marcuse proposes a new kind of socialist revolution, a socialist revolution based on the sexual revolution, as a sexual revolution. It's clear? You got it? But Marcuse's, thank you very much, Miss Francesca. Marcuse's new theory of Marxist socialist revolution is based especially on our subjectivity, but also on the objectivity. So Marcuse, in this sense, Marcuse claims that the subjective socialist revolution has an objective condition as well. This objective condition is the technological development of the 20th century, because it has, now this technological development has produced a great increase of the economic productivity, For this, nowadays, it would be possible for everybody to work much less than ever. It would be possible for everybody to work much less than ever in our human history. In other words, nowadays the technological progress is enough to eliminate the capitalistic power, i.e. to substitute a socialistic economy for a capitalistic one. You got it? We are arriving to the end, to a happy end. So thanks to the high productivity in the socialistic society, it will be possible that everybody has much more spare time and a free and complete sexual life, without economic problems. Without any economic problem. In other words, according to Marcuse, it will be possible to work less, but the same, to have a high standard of living. In this way, it will be also possible the sexual liberation. That means enjoying all kinds of sexuality, not only the genital one. And especially, it will be possible living sexuality as a free play, that is, as an aim, not as a means. As an aim, not as a means. This is, in Marcuse's view, this is the sexual liberation. Possible only in a new socialistic society. So, I've finished. Any question? All clear? You got it? Yes, not? So, we have finished. All clear. Thank you very much, Miss Francesca. I know that I am speaking with you almost. No, at least with you. So I basta. Vi saluto. Aurora, thank you very much, Miss Aurora. All clear. Our philosophy program is at the end. We are arrived. We have arrived. What a mistake! We have arrived to the end of our philosophy program. So. Break a leg for your exams, and I hope we will see ourselves a day. I don't know when. In the future. Goodbye. With 2 minutes before. Arrivederci Alessandra, arrivederci Marianna. Break a leg. For your examinations. Thank you. Goodbye. Bye-bye.